Hey there folks, welcome to another LEGO set review. This is the small one. This is 75321, the Razor Crest Microfighter from LEGO Star Wars. This is actually the first Microfighter that I've personally owned. I think my favorite one would probably be either the X-Wing or, let's see, the Red 5 X-Wing that they made, or the Clone Turbo Tank. One of those two. Both of them are great. All the Microfighters, I think, for a majority, are pretty good. I've never gotten them in the past, mainly because they're just really small. And, like, I guess they have good figures, but I prefer the larger sets, you know. But anyway, this is the Razor Crest as a Microfighter. And so, yeah, it's got 98 pieces, one minifigure, and it retails for $10 in the U.S., and it's pretty cheap, you know. It does come with the Mandalorian, with his jetpack. This is like the third set that he comes with this. Or no, the second set that comes with him with the jetpack. So yeah. Before we take a look at the Microfighter itself, I will actually be comparing this to the full-size Razor Crest in a little bit. But here is the minifigure of the Mandalorian, Din Djarin. Hopefully the quality's good. He's got excellent detail, great helmet. On the box, I will say the visor is higher than on the actual helmet, so this is lower than, like, as the box shows. So I'm going to bring the box in for just a brief moment. I don't know if you can tell. Hopefully you can. But see the helmet right there? That's printed higher, and on the actual size image, it shows the visor being higher. Unfortunately, it's a little bit lower, the visor, on the actual figure, but that's fine. Doesn't matter that much. Just wanted to give you a bit of trivia, I guess. Helmet's great. There is no face for him. It's just a black head. There is back printing. You can see that in Minifig Monday. He's got the jetpack. There actually is a set now with his face, which is awesome. It is the Mandalorian's N1 Starfighter from the Book of Boba Fett. That's available now. So you can get that set, and he's got a face in there. He has a beautiful arm printing. Look at that, that's awesome. Very excellent detailing everywhere. This is the Beskar armor. It's very shiny, very great. I will admit, I prefer the earlier Mandalorian minifig that they made in 2019, the first one that they did. But this one is equally as good. So yeah, Mandalorian minifig, great way to get him. It's a cheap way, affordable, and yeah, great figure. I'm just going to move him to the side here so we can take a look at the Razor Crest Microfighter itself. It's actually really well designed. I kind of hated on this set early, like when it was revealed. However, I think it is actually not too bad looking. I will say the weakest parts of this are definitely this right here. This landing gear is just two studs in black just put together. That looks bad in my opinion. The holes on the side of the engines look pretty bad, but that's just how the pieces are made. It does look rather blocky on the top. It looks fairly good. The front of the cockpit, it looks a little bit weird, but it's not that bad of an issue. The new stud shooters are cool. This is really the only feature of this. Well, I guess technically it has two features. There is a landing ramp actually at the back of the ship, which can actually lower, which is cool. There's nothing in there, but you can, you know, make it look like it's, you know, landed, and you can lower it. That's cool. I like that. I love the engine detailing. That is great with the orange studs. I think the best looking side of this is actually the back of it. This looks most like the ship, this back section here. The more you get to the front, it looks a little bit less like it, but I think it looks enough like the Razor Crest. Like, it's got the escape pod on the top, it's got the big engines, it's got the cockpit, the roundness on the front, the ramps on the sides, the dark tan looks good, these slopes look really good. But the stud shooters are really cool. They actually look really nice on this model, and if you wanted to, you can actually fire those off by pressing down like this, and it should launch them into oblivion. You'll never see them again. But it gives you more. So I think actually think that these look better without the studs. It looks much more clean. But yeah, you can put the studs in there, load them up like so, just put them in like that, and there you go. And you can put the Mandalorian, you can sit him in there if you want to, like, put him in there. It's, what's nice is there's actually room for his jetpack to be, like, not in the way. So when you put him in, it actually looks pretty proper. It looks like he's flying it. Yeah, it looks really nice. For the most part, I think it was really well designed. Probably going to give this build probably an 8 out of 10. I think they could have maybe done a little bit better, like maybe smooth it out a little bit more, especially around the front and maybe on the top. And yeah, I really wish these holes were not here, but you can't do anything about that. But yeah, I think it's really great. Let me do a quick comparison. Let me take the Mando out of the way for just a minute. Let me bring in the first Razor Crest, the official playset. Let me get it. It's a bit big. Hopefully you can see this. So here is the Razor Crest, the full-size version, and here is the Microfighter down here. And as you can see, it's very small. Obviously, it's a Microfighter, so it's like a small ship, which is appropriate. I believe you can actually fit the Microfighter in the inside the larger version. I believe. I haven't tried it yet, but I might try that just to see if it'll work. If you can get either of these, definitely do so. The full-size one is pretty pricey, but if you can get it for a good deal, definitely get it. I've done a review on it. It's a fantastic set, in my opinion. One of my favorites. It's just amazing as a set in general. Very useful, very, you know, detailed, accurate, very nice to play with. And this version is pretty much the same thing. I will say the Microfighter is really well affordable. It's got a great minifig. It's got great parts, and it looks pretty proper as a set. So yeah, I'll take this larger version out of the way. And honestly, I would recommend this set, especially if you're a fan of the Mandalorian, or if you're a Lego Mandalorian fan, or if you want something from the show but it's not too big and you don't want to break your wallet. The Razor Crest Microfighter is a great way to go. $10, you can get this in another set, and it's well worth it, I think. It's pretty good. So I like this set. I really like it. I prefer the large version, but I think this is a great complement to that. I hope you enjoyed this review. Let me know if you have this set in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one, and take care.